Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So, we're going through Srimad Bhagavatam, and we were on the fifth canto, and we were hearing from chapter 18 about the prayers offered to the Lord by the residents of Jambudweep. So we've nearly finished the chapter, just a couple of verses left. We were hearing the prayers offered to Lord Varaha. So the residents in this particular dweep where Lord Varaha is worshipped, they pray to Lord Varaha that he actually doesn't desire the creation. He doesn't want the creation or the maintenance or the annihilation of the material world.
在这个祷文中我们可以看到主瓦拉哈他其实并不希望这个物质世界创造维系和被毁灭。
But he does these things for the benefit of the conditioned souls.
但是他做这一切是为了受条件限制的灵魂。
And he does it by using his Srishti Shakti, what is called the power to create, the energy to create.
他是通过他的 Shakti, 这个力量被称为创造的能量。
So the same way, when the Lord glances over anything matter, then then he can move it simply by his glance.
只是通过主的一个瞥视，这个物质才可以运，才可以行动。
So sometimes people ask, why would God create this material world where so much suffering, where people are suffering so much in this world?
有些时候人们会问出这样的问题，为什么至尊主要创造这个充满痛苦的物质世界？
So that question is answered by this prayer which is offered.
在这个祷文中就给出了这个问题的答案。
Yeah, the Lord, he doesn't want to create the material world. He doesn't want to do all this creation, maintenance, and destruction. He does it for the benefit of the conditioned souls.
事实上主他不想创造这个物质世界创造维系和毁灭他做这一切的目的只是为了受条件限制的灵魂。
So what, does it mean the Lord wants them all to suffer?
难道是主希望我们在这里受苦吗?
No, the Lord creates the material world because we want the world to enjoy. We want to enjoy. We think we're going to enjoy in this world. So he does it to satisfy our desire.
不是的，主创造这个世界是因为我们想在这个物质世界里享受。
And another point in this prayer is that material nature doesn't, what happens in this material world, the working of nature, it doesn't happen automatically. There has to be the Lord to put it into action.
这一节诗里面还有一个要点，就是说。 物质能量它不是自动运行的，它必须有主注入它的能量的时候，它才能够运行，才能活动。
But you've got atheistic people like scientists and Sankhya philosophers. They think that there's no God behind the world.
但是物质主义这些科学家、无神论者，还有这些Samkhya哲学的这些人，他们认为物质，他们认为这个物质自然的背后没有神。
So they think that everything which happens in the world is just going on by chance.
他们认为物质自然的这一切只是由于只是由于某种原因就自然而然就运动的。
Yeah, they think the material nature itself causes the creation.
他们认为物质自然自己创造出来的。
In other words, they think life comes from matter.
他们认为生命来自于物质。
They do not understand material energy has no power to move. It cannot act independently.
他们不理解物质自然没有能量独自运行。
But because the Lord is behind everything, He gives it the power to move.
因为主在一切的背后，他给予力量让一切能够行动。
Just like we see the ocean, we see so many big waves are moved on the ocean, but they don't just move on their own, they're moved by the air. It's the air which causes them to move.
就像我们看到大海上面有很多的波浪，这个波浪不是自动运行的，海不可能造成波浪自动运行，是空气的推动造成了这个波浪的产生。
And the air comes from ether.
空气又被以太所创造。
And the ether is produced by the three modes of nature.
以太产生于物质自然的三种属性。
And the three modes of nature are due to Krishna's glance over the material energy.
物质自然三属性又是由于至尊主的瞥视而产生的能量。
So we can understand everything that happens in this world is actually due to the personality of Godhead. He's behind everything.
因此我们可以看到所有一切都由至尊主在背后，一切都由至尊主控制着。
Material nature itself is just dead matter. It cannot do anything on its own.
物质自然实际上是一种死的，它不可能自己去做一些事情。
But Krishna, by his mercy, he puts energy into the dead matter.
但是由于 Krishna 的仁慈，至尊主的仁慈，他把能量注入到这些死的元素里面。
And that way the dead matter becomes, it's like the secondary cause of everything. It's not the, not the initial cause, it's the secondary cause.
所以物质能量是第二个原因，而主是首要的原因。
Krishna is the original cause.
主 Krishna 是原初的原因。
And material nature is just like the nipples on the neck of a goat.
物质自然就好像山羊上脖子的那个乳头。
The nipples on the neck of a goat, they cannot give any milk.
山羊的脖子上的这个乳头，它挤不出奶。
So materialistic people, atheists, philosophers, they cannot understand how material nature moves. They cannot, they think it's moving on its own.
物质主义科学家和这些无神论者，他们无法理解这个物质自然的行运动，他们认为他们是独自行动的。
But the devotees know behind everything there is the Supreme Lord.
但是奉献者知道在一切的背后有至尊主。
And then the final prayer they say to the Lord Varaha that you are the original board within the universe.
在这个祷文的背后，这个祷文这么写的：您作为这个宇宙中最原始的雄猪。
And you fought and killed the great demon Hiranyaksha.
您与这个大恶魔Hiranyaksha作战。
Hiranyaksha was the brother of Hiranyakashipu, and he was They were two sons of Kashyapa and Diti.
黑人亚克沙是黑人卡西普的这个兄弟，他们都是卡夏帕和迪提的儿子。
So Hiranyaksha was going everywhere looking for gold, and he was looking for a fight, somebody to fight him. So then he met Lord Varaha.
黑人亚克沙总是在这个寻找想要跟他打仗的这个人，然后他就找到了瓦拉哈。
And Lord Varaha killed him.
然后主瓦拉哈杀死了他。
Then Lord Varaha picked up the earth from the Garbhadak ocean on the end of his tusk.
瓦拉哈接着就把地球从 Garbhadaksha 这个海洋之中给举了起来。
Srimad Bhagavatam describes how Swayambhuva Manu and his wife Satarupa, they were asked to procreate the universe to help Lord Brahma to fill up the universe with population.
圣殿博加瓦坦讲述了斯瓦扬布瓦马鲁和他的妻子是被要求 they are asked to
fill up the universe with population.
为这个地球生产人口，繁衍人口。
They were asked by Lord Brahma.
是 Brahma 要求他们这么做。
Right, Brahma was their father.
Brahma 是父亲。
So they said to Lord Brahma, they said, well, the earth is in the bottom of the universe. The earth had fallen into the bottom of the universe. So they said, can we pick up, can we somehow get the earth out from the bottom of the universe and put it back in position?
他们跟这个主 Brahma 说，现在这个地球在这个宇宙的底部，在这个在这个 Garbhadaksha 洋中之中，能否请求您把这个，能否请求把这个地球放回它原来的位置上呢？
So at that time, Lord Varaha appeared from the nostril of Brahma, and then he grew very, very big, and then he went and dived into the Garbhadak ocean and picked up the earth.
所以在那个时候 ，Varaha 就显现了。他展现得非常非常大，从这个 Garbhadaksha 海洋中把地球给顶了起来，举了起来。
And he took birth. He came out from the nose of Brahma.
他是从这个 Brahma 的鼻子中出生的。
But then he grew, expanded. He became very big.
但是他从他的鼻子中呼吸出来之后。变得非常非常的大，不断不断的扩展。
And he picked up the earth planet just like an elephant would pick a lotus flower from the water.
他从这个海洋中，把这个地球举起来，就像一个大象从这个水中举起一朵莲花那么容易。
All right, we'll go on to the next chapter. That's chapter number 19.Which is a description of the island of Jambudweep.
下面我们继续学习第十九章。这一章的标题是对 Jambudweep 岛的描述。
And it's continuing with more prayers from different parts of Jambudweep.
这一章继续是 Jambudweep 的一些其他的部分的居民对主供奉的祷文。
So Sukadeva Goswami is speaking to Maharaj Parikshit.And he's telling him, there's a place in Jambudweep called Kimpurusha Varsha.
Shukadeva Goswami 对 Parikshita Maharaj 说，在这个 Kimpurusha Varsha 的这个地方。
And there, the great devotee Hanuman lives. He's always doing devotional service.
在这个地方有一个伟大的奉献者哈努曼，很常在那里做奉献服务。
And he's always serving. Hanuman, of course, is a great devotee of Lord Rama, and he serves also the brother of Lord Rama. The brother is Lakshman, and the husband of Rama is Sita Devi. So Hanuman serves all of them.
在那片土地上，哈努曼他因为是主 Rama 的伟大的奉献者，他在那里一直从事着对主 Rama 还有 Lakshman 还有 Sita Devi 的奉献服务。
Rama is Gurga, Lakshman is Didi.
Rama is Lakshman is Didi, Rama is Gurga.
So, there are many also Gandharvas who are there, and they also chant the glories of Lord Ramachandra.
在那里还有一些 Gandharva, 他们也唱诵主 Ramachandra 的荣耀。
The Gandharvas, they can sing and dance very beautifully. They're very wonderful musicians.
这些 Gandharva, 他们可以唱和跳舞都非常好，他们非常擅长音乐。
So they're chanting, when you hear the chanting is very, very powerful and auspicious.
他们的唱诵非常有力量和吉祥。
So in this Kimpurusha Varsha, the chief people are Hanumanji and also Arishtasena. Arishtasena.
在这个 Kimpurusha 的首席人物是 Hanumanji 和 Arishtasena.
And they constantly hear with very fixed attention, they hear about Lord Ramachandra.
他们全神贯注地聆听主 Ramachandra 的。
Hanuman will chant the mantra, and Arishtasena will hear.
Hanuman 唱诵祷文， Arishtasena 他是聆听。
So it's described there are different opinions about who is Lord Rama and who is Lakshman and who is Sita. The different scriptures say different things.
在不同的经典中对 Lakshman, Rama 和 Sita, 就是说他们几个人不同做出了不同的描述，身份做出了不同的描述。
Lord Rama actually has three brothers. One is Lakshman, the other is Bharat and Shatrughna. So, one scripture says that they are incarnations of Vasudev, Sankarshan, Prajumna and Aniruddha.
主 Rama 有他的三个弟弟 Lakshman, Bharat, Shatrughna.
Shatrughna.
有一些经典说他们分别是 Vasudeva, Sankarsana 和 Padumana, 还有 Aniruddha.
Right. But another scripture... Right. So different opinions about the identity of who they are.
所以对于他们到底是谁有不同的这个意见。
And Lord Rama's residence on this planet, his residence is at Ayodhya city.
主 Ramachandra 在这个地球上，他住在 Ayodhya 这个城。
There's a big river just beside Ayodhya. The Sarayu, river Sarayu is there beside Ayodhya.
在Ayodhya 的旁边有个 Sarayu 的一条河。
So that's the capital city of Lord Ramachandra. His palace was there.
这个是主 Ramachandra 的所在的这个地方，他的宫殿在那里。
So we're going to hear the prayers which Hanuman offers to glorify Lord Ramachandra.
下面我们来听 Hanuman 供奉的祷文。
So Hanuman says that I offer my obeisances to Lord Rama, who is the personality of Godhead, and he's the most highly elevated personality.
Hanuman 祈祷道：“我向至尊人格守神寄前进的顶拜，他是最高尚的人物。”
And Hanuman says that his behavior and character are always perfectly controlled, and his mind and senses are always perfectly controlled.
他祈祷道：“这个最高尚的，他向主说， 这个最高尚的人物，他的行为和品格总是高度的控制，他也能恒常的控制住自己的心意。
He describes Lord Rama always acts in a perfect manner to teach others how they should behave.
他总是模范的品格，教导他人如何行为举止。
And he acts just like he's an ordinary human being, although he's the Supreme Lord.
虽然他是至尊主，但是他像普通人一般行为。
And he says Lord Ramachandra is like a touchstone which helps other people to develop good qualities.
他说主 Ramachandra 他就像试金石一样，能够帮助普通大众提升他们的品质。
And he's worshipped by the Brahmanas.
他被这些婆罗门所崇拜。
And he's the supreme, Lord Rama is the supreme person, the king of all kings.
主 Rama 是至尊的人，他是王中之王。
And his form is Sachid Ananda Vigraha.
他的形体是 Sachid Ananda Vigraha.
In the Vedas, he is described.To be one without a second.
在维丹塔中，他被描述为是独一无二的人物。
But he cannot be understood by material vision.
但是他不可能被物质的这种视域所理解。
Because he is always transcendental, he has no material activities.
因为他总是处于超然之中，他没有物质的活动。
So unless a person is Krishna conscious, unless he's very pure, he cannot understand the transcendental form of the Lord.
除非他处在纯粹的 Krishna 知觉之中，否则他不能够觉察到主的超然形体。
So Hanuman prays to have his mind fixed at the lotus feet of Lord Ramachandra.
Hanuman 希望愿他的内心总是专注于主的莲花足。
So, Lord Rama, that Lord Krishna has many incarnations. We know he has many, many incarnations, and Lord Rama is one of these incarnations.
我们知道主 Krishna 有很多的化身，主 Ramachandra 只是其中的一个化身。
But it's Krishna who's the original personality of Godhead.
但是 Krishna 是原初的那位至尊人格首身。
But he expands himself into different forms like Lord Ramachandra.
但是他扩展他自己以各种形象，超然的形象，其中一个是 Rama。
So we may wonder, is it possible that Lord Ramachandra can be like Lord Vishnu or like Lord Krishna.
有些时候我们会想，主 Rama 他是 Vishnu 或者说是 Krishna 吗？
Because Lord Rama doesn't have four hands, and he doesn't have the conch shell and the club and the Sudarshan Chakra.
因为主 Rama 他并没有四只手。他也没有海螺，也没有神碟。
And he had to be carried by Hanuman. He's carried by Hanuman, not by Garuda.
他是被 Hanuman 所背着，而不是被 Garuda 所扶着。
But according to this verse in the Srimad Bhagavatam, it says Lord Ramachandra is as good as Krishna.
但是在这件事中，我们清楚地看到，主 Ramachandra 和 Krishna 一样的好。
Although Krishna is the original personality of Godhead, Lord Rama is not different from him.
虽然 Krishna 是原本的至尊人格首身，但是主 Ramachandra 和主 Krishna 没有分别。
But if we want to understand that, we have to be pure. We have to come to the transcendental platform. Then we can appreciate the transcendental position of Lord Ramachandra.
因为主，如果我们想理解主 Ramachandra 的这个超然的地位，我们必须有超有这种纯粹的这种知觉才行。
You cannot,
我们才能够欣赏主 Rama 的这种超然的地位。
You cannot see him with material eyes.
我们不可能用我们物质的眼睛去看到主 Rama。
Demons like Ravana, he didn't have any spiritual vision, so he thought Lord Rama was an ordinary man.
像这些恶魔，比如 Ravana 这样的恶魔，他们没有灵性的视觉，他所以看到这个主 Rama， 他只是一个普通的人。
So Ravana tried to kidnap Lord Ramachandra's wife, Mother Sita.
因此。Ravana 就试图绑架主 Ramachandra 的妻子 Sita Devi.
But Ravana cannot touch Mother Sita because Mother Sita is very pure.
但是 Ravana 他不可能触碰到 Sita， 因为 Sita 母亲非常的纯粹。
So when Ravana came to try to touch Sita, Mother Sita manifested a material form, and Ravana took a Maya form of Sita.
一旦希塔 Devi 被这个 Ravana 触碰的时候，希塔 Devi 就立刻扩展出自己的一个物质的形象，所以 Ravana 他触碰的是希塔 Devi 的物质的这个形体。
And Mother Sita, she just disappeared in her pure spiritual form. She made her spiritual form invisible.
他让他希塔 Devi 让他的灵性的这个形体处于隐形的状态。
So Lord Ramachandra and his wife Sita, they're not of the material energy. They're completely spiritual.
主 Ramachandra 和他的妻子希塔，他们是远离于物质能量的影响。
Just like we cannot see the Paramatma unless we have.A lot of pure devotion.
就像我们不可能看到 Paramatma， 就是这个超灵，除非我们有这种纯粹的知觉。
The Atma, we have the individual Atma, the Jivatma, and the Paramatma. They're two separate identities.
我们有这个 Atma 和 Paramatma 两个不同的实体。
So.Our body is made up of three elements, fire, earth, and water.
我们的身体由物质这个躯体由三种元素构成，土、水、火。
Of course, there's some air, there's some ether, but mainly it's fire, earth, and water.
当然也会有一些空气和液态，但是主要的是土、水、火。
So the Paramatma,comes into the heart of the jiva, into the heart of the individual living entity.
Paramatma 进入到个体生物的内心。
But the Paramatma doesn't have anything to do with the body of the living entity.
但是 Paramatma 它并不和这个物质躯体有什么关系。
Paramatma doesn't have any material connections.
Paramatma 不和这个物质有什么联系。
He doesn't have any material identity.
他没有物质的身份。
But the Jivatma does have a material identity.
超灵没有物质身份，但是个体灵魂有物质的身份。
Yeah, the Jivatma, the Jiva, the living entity, he's thinking himself to be Indian or American or German, whatever.
个体灵魂他可能会认为自己是个印度人、美国人、德国人等等。
But Paramatma doesn't have anything or doesn't think anything like that.
但是超灵他不会有这种认为，他没有这种物质的名称。
Paramatma doesn't have any material name.
超灵也没有物质的名字。
The Jivatma, he has names, but he's different from his name.
这个个体灵魂他有他的名字，但是个体灵魂又不同于他的名字。
But the Paramatma, he doesn't have any material name.
但是超灵他没有 任何物质的名字。
And Paramatma doesn't have any false ego.
超灵也没有假我。
Because he knows his transcendental identity.
因为超灵他知道他超然的身份。
So it's not that Lord Ramachandra doesn't have any identity, but he's completely spiritual. He's not material.
不是说这个主 Ramachandra 他没有任何的身份，只是说他是超然的，不是物质的。
Yeah, he has his personal identity, but he has his personal identity.
他有他的个人的身份。
But he's not of this material world.
但他不属于这个物质世界。
So Hanuman then goes on to talk about how Ravan, he was the chief of the Rakshasas.And he couldn't be killed by anyone except for a human being.
Hanuman 继续描述了这个恶魔的首领 Raksha 的首领 Ravana, 他不可能被任何所杀，他只可能被一个人类所杀。
So that's why Lord Ramachandra, that's why the Supreme Lord came in the form of a human being. Lord Ramachandra is the Supreme Lord.But he came as a human being so that he could keep that boon intact.
所以就因为这个原因，为此原因，至尊人格守神主 Ramachandra 以人类的这个形体显现。虽然他是至尊主，但他以人类的形体显现。
Because Ravan had a boon, he did great austerities and he got a blessing from Lord Shiva that nobody would kill him.Except a human being, he couldn't be killed by anyone except a human being.
因为 Ravana 他得到一个祝福，被 Shiva 祝福，他不可能被任何人杀死，只可能被一个人类所杀死。
Because Ravan thought no human being will ever be able to kill him. Human beings are not; they don't have any kind of strength equal to Ravan.
因为 Ravana 他认为。不可能有任何的人类可以杀死他，一个人类的力量不足以杀死他，所以他不认为人类可以杀死他。
So Lord Ramachandra is actually the Supreme Lord, but he came in a human form.
所以 Ramachandra 他以这个人类的形体显现，但是他是至尊人格守神本人。
And he comes, his purpose is not only just to kill Ravan.But to teach all of us that you can't be happy in material life.
主 Ramachandra 的使命不仅仅是为了来杀死 Ravana, 他还教育我们所有的人，在这个物质世界是不可能有快乐的。
That if you try to find happiness just on around just being around our wife, and just based on sex.You will never get, that will just bring you so many miseries. It won't bring you real happiness.
如果你只是想以性生活和以妻子为中心的这种物质快乐，它只会给你带来痛苦，没有快乐可言。
But for Lord Ramachandra, he's the Supreme Lord. He doesn't have to lament for anything. He's not going to suffer.
作为至尊人格守神的主 Ramachandra,他是神本人，他不可能会悲伤。
And that's why he wants to show us the troubles and the difficulties which he goes through when his wife is kidnapped.
但是他来到这个世界只是为了显示，为了展示，当他的妻子被绑架时候的这种情况。
So Lord Ramachandra, just like in Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna describes that when he comes, His mission is to give pleasure to the devotees and kill the demons.
就像博迦梵歌中描述的，当主来到这个物质世界的，来到这个世界显现的时候，他消灭恶魔，保护奉献者。
So by his own example, Lord Ramachandra taught them that you have to be careful about married life.
通过主 Ramachandra 的亲身的这个例子，他教导他们非常小心，在这个家庭生活中要非常小心。
So miserly people who don't have much spiritual knowledge, they usually go to family life, and their purpose is just for sex.
有很多这些物质主义者，他们的主要的愿望就是想进入到婚姻生活。他们想进去的主要原因就是为了性生活。
And they have sex, they will enjoy sex again and again, and they're never satisfied. Even though they suffer, even though they get so much suffering.
即便他在这个夫妻的生活之中想遭受了很多的痛苦，但是他们还是一再的又一再的想享受这个性生活。
So to teach people, Lord Ramachandra, who's the Supreme Lord, he accepted all these troubles which came about him because of his wife.
为了教导人们，所以主 Ramachandra 接受了这个身份，当就是说有这个妻子的这个情况，所以他经历了这一切的苦难，他是为了教导人们。
Of course, Lord Ramachandra had accepted a wife. He'd taken Sita for his wife, and when he went to the forest, she wanted to go with him, so he took her, he let her come with him. But then she got kidnapped.
主 Ramachandra 接受了一位妻子。当主 Ramachandra 想要去森林的时候，他不想让他们去。但是呢，他们又想让他，但是呢，他的妻子和他的这个兄弟又想跟着他去。
Lord Ramachandra.
然而在最后时候，他的妻子又被绑架了。
Lord Ramachandra is the Supreme Lord. He doesn't need to lament about anything, but he wants to teach us.
主 Ramachandra 是至尊人格守神本人，他不会为任何的物质的事情而悲伤，但是他只是为了教导我们。
So by his own example, he's showing us how difficult it is to enjoy material life.
通过他个人的亲身的这个事情，他给我们树立的一个情况，就是想要在这个物质世界享受是多么困难的一件事情。
And Lord Ramachandra also shows us that when we accept a wife, we must be a faithful husband, and we must give the wife full protection.
主 Ramachandra 还给我们另外一个启示教导，是要接受一位妻子，人必须做一个很忠实的丈夫。必须给这个妻子全面的保护。
So Lord Ramachandra, by his example, showed us how to take care of our wife and how to give proper protection and care for them.
主 Ramachandra 通过他的榜样告诉我们如何保护和照顾他们妻子。
We should be able to provide all facilities to protect the wife.
我们应该提供一切的这些设施来保护妻子。
Even though there may be difficulties, it may be a lot of trouble for us, but it's the duty of a husband.
即便在这个实践的过程中会有很多的困难，但是那是一位丈夫的职责。
So Lord Ramachandra, he showed how to perform that duty.
主 Ramachandra 展示了这个榜样，他如何去履行他的职责。
Lord Ramachandra, the Supreme Lord, he could have produced many, many Sitas to take the place of the one Sita who disappeared.
主 Ramachandra 他是至尊人格守神本人，他可以创造出成千上万的这个希塔，当希塔消失的时候。
But he wants to show how to be a faithful husband.
但是他展示了一位忠实的丈夫的这个榜样。
So when Sita was kidnapped, he killed Ravana and he rescued Sita.
所以当 Ravana 绑架了 Sita 的时候，他拯救了这个 Sita， 杀了 Ravana。
And another point is to understand that although it appears that Lord Ramachandra is suffering material pains, he's always transcendental.
还有另外一个教导是，即便这个主他经历了各种各样的物质苦难，他仍然是保持他的超然的。
So the separation of Lord Ramachandra from Sita, that was also their bliss, that was transcendental bliss, because they could experience the separation.
当主 Ramachandra 和 Sita Devi 即便是处于分离的状态中的时候，也是处于超然的极乐的分离之情之中的。
And that pain of separation increases their love for each other.
他们的分离之苦增长了他们之间的爱。
Then Hanuman continues praying to Lord Rama. He says, Lord Rama is Vasudev. He is not attached to anything in the material world.
Hanuman 继续祈祷道，主 Ramachandra 是至尊人格守神 Vasudeva， 他不依附于这个物质世界的任何事物。
He is the super soul.Of all the self-realized souls.
他是所有觉悟自我灵魂的超灵。
And he is a very intimate friend.
他是非常十分亲密的朋友。
And he has all opulences.
他拥有所有的富裕。
So he could not suffer because of separation from his wife.
他不可能因为与妻子的分离而受苦。
And he could never give up his wife, and he could never give up his brother Lakshman.
他不可能放弃他的妻子和他的弟弟 Lakshman.
It would be impossible for him to give them up.
他是不可能放弃任何一位的。
So Lord Ramachandra, this Bhagavan, he has all the opulence, he's not attached to anything in this world.
主 Rama 是至尊人格守神，他有六项富裕，他不可能依附于这个物质世界的任何一些事物。
He is attached to the spiritual world, and he is attached to the living entities in the spiritual world.
但是他依恋灵性世界和灵性世界里的生物。
The material world is under the control of Durga, Mother Durga.
物质世界里的事物是被多尔嘎母亲监督。
So Lord Ramachandra, he does not need to give any attention to the material world.
主 Ramachandra 他不怎么关心这个物质世界。
And Sita, she belongs to the spiritual world, and so does Lakshman.
Sita Devi 和 Lakshman 也是属于灵性世界的。
So they're from the spiritual world. They don't have anything to do with the material world.
他们是来自于灵性世界，与这个物质世界是没有什么关系的。
And Lord Ramachandra, he's attached to his devotees, his servants, who are always giving him service.
主 Ramachandra, 他总是依附于他的奉献者和他的仆人们，那些恒常服务他的奉献者们。
He's not attached to Brahminical qualities.
他不怎么依附非 Brahma 的品质，不怎么依附 Brahma 的这些品质。
He's not attached to any material qualities.
他也不依附于任何物质的品质。
But he is the super soul of all living entities.
他是所有众生心中的超灵。
And those who are self-realized, they know who is where is Lord Ramachandra? They understand him.
那些觉悟了自我的灵魂，他们能知道谁是主 Ramachandra。
So Lord Ramachandra came to this world to show how to be a good king and how to perform the duty properly.
主 Ramachandra 的降临是为了教导人类如何成为一个恰当的国王，如何恰当的行为。
It appears like Lord Ramachandra gave up the company of Mother Sita and Lakshman, but actually he never gave them up.
表面上他放弃了母亲西塔和拉什曼的陪伴，事实上他不可能放弃他们。
He could not give them up.
他不会放弃他们。
You have to understand about Lord Ramachandra's activities by hearing from a good devotee. Then you can understand the real activities of Lord Rama.
我们应该从一位觉悟了自我的一位奉献者那里去了解主 Ramachandra 的活动，这样才能理解主 Ramachandra 的超然的活动。
Okay, we'll stop here. Ask if there's any questions.
好，我们先讲到这儿。看一看大家有什么问题。
我们稍等一会儿吧，暂时还没有问题。
Did we get any questions?
Not yet.
Maybe we should keep going.
Okay.
Okay, Hanuman's still praying to Lord Ramachandra. He says, you cannot make friends with Lord Ramachandra simply by material qualities.
Hanuman 继续祈祷道，人不可能和主 Ramachandra 的友谊建立在物质品质的基础之上。
Even though you may be born in a great family, you may be a very big man, you may be very good looking, you may be very intelligent, that won't help you to make friends with Lord Ramachandra.
即便你出生在一个高贵的家庭，拥有很非常非常的美丽，而且是个大人物等等这些很优越的物质条件，但是这些品质都不是和主 Ramachandra 建立友谊的前提。
And Hanuman says, he said, just look at me. He said, people like me, we're uncivilized. We come from the forest. We don't have a good birth.
哈努曼说道，像我们这些人，我们是森林里面这些非常根本没有什么文明的人，我们也没有什么高贵的出身，躯体也不那么美丽。
And Hanuman says, yeah, yes, I'm not very beautiful, have no beauty, and I cannot speak very nicely, but Lord Ramachandra has accepted us, all the monkeys, as friends.
哈努曼说道，像我们这些人躯体也不那么的美丽，也没有很好的谈吐，说话也不那么好听，但是主 Ramachandra 就是接受我们这些猴子作为他的朋友。
So people often who have the wealth and beauty, education, they're often very proud of these things.
通常一个人他如果有地位、有物质的财富、有美丽，受到一些教育，他就会感到很骄傲。
Well, they're certainly is good things. They're good things to have, but we have to know how to use them.
当然，有这些事情，有这些好的东西是很好的，但是人应该知道怎么运用这些东西。
Right, we want to use them in the service of Krishna or in the service of the Supreme Lord.
我们应该把这些事情、这些东西用于服务 Krishna, 用于服务主。
So you have to become a devotee, and then you can use your good looks and your money and your power and all, everything you have, you can use everything for Krishna's service.
当一个人成为奉献者的时候，他才可以把这个出身、富裕、教育、美丽用于对 Krishna 的奉献服务之中。
But we often people, they don't even care about material qualification. Well, Krishna doesn't care about material qualifications. Other people, they care about them.
但是至尊人格守神对这些物质品质并不很在意，但是其他的那些人，他们很在意这些物质上的财富等等。
They don't care about Krishna consciousness. They only care about material life.
他们只是在意这些物质的这些东西，他们在意的是物质的生命。
But if one wants to get Krishna, if one wants to get devotion, if one wants to get the shelter of the Lord, you have to have the desire. You have to be very sincere and have also devotion.
如果一个人想得到 Krishna, 想得到这个奉献服务，想得到至尊主的话，他需要真诚和渴望，还需要一些奉爱。
Right, we should be sincere and we should want to serve, give service to the Lord. That's qualification.
我们应该真诚的想去服务主，这是我们的唯一的资格。
And we should be very eager. We should have even agreed to get this opportunity to be the servant of the Lord.
甚至我们应该有这种热切的渴望，甚至贪婪的想要得到这种去服务主的机会。
Yeah, that's the only price. That's the qualification to get the connection with the Lord. You have to really want it very badly.
如果我们想真的和主建立起连接的话，我们要有这种渴望，非常强烈的渴望才行。
And Lord Krishna won't accept any other price. You can't change. You can't get a discount. You can't compromise. You can't change anything. You have to have that very intense desire to get it.
主 Krishna 不会改变这个事情的任何的价格。他不会说，把这个事情改变成别的，或者说给你打个折扣什么。我们必须要真诚的，而且非常强烈的渴望才行，这是唯一的条件。
And Prabhupada gives it. He said, just like Kolavika Sridhar, he was very poor. He didn't have any money. He had only a few banana trees, and he was just taking the skin of the banana tree to make pots, and he would sell them.
圣帕帕德给了一个例子，说到 Kolavika Sridhar 这个奉献者，他是一个很贫穷的 Brahmana 了，但他只有一些香蕉树制成的罐子，还有一些香蕉树，他只是靠卖一些香蕉来获得他的收入。卖香蕉树制成的罐子来获得他的收入。
So,
但是他是一个很伟大的奉献者。
Whatever income he got, he would spend half of it to worship Mother Ganga.
无论他有多少的收入，他都用50%去崇拜恒河母亲。
But he was always very poor, and his house was a mess. His house had holes in the roof.
他总是非常的贫穷，他住的这个小茅屋。有很多的窟窿。
And he would drink water from an iron pot. He didn't even have a brass pot to drink water.
他买不起这些铜的器皿，他只能用这个铁罐子喝水。
But he was a great devotee, and Lord Chaitanya loved him and respected him.
他是一个伟大的奉献者，主 Chaitanya 非常爱他，也非常尊重他。
So even though one is very poor, you can become a great devotee.
因此，即便一个人非常的贫穷，他也有可能会成为一个很伟大的奉献者。
But that doesn't mean that all poor people are devotees.
但是这并不意味着所有的这些穷人就是奉献者。
Just because we're poor doesn't mean we get the mercy of Krishna.
不能说你很贫穷，你就能得到这个 Krishna 的仁慈。
But you need to do devotional service. If we do devotional service, then we can get the mercy of Krishna.
我们通过做奉献服务，然后才得到 Krishna 的仁慈。
So Hanuman said, everybody should worship Lord Ramachandra. It doesn't matter if you're a demigod or a demon, or a man or a beast or a bird.
Hanuman 继续祈祷道，无论你是半神人、恶魔、人，或者说什么生物，都应该崇拜至尊人格守神 Ramachandra.
You don't need to do great austerities or penances to worship him.
你不用做巨大的苦行或忏悔去崇拜他。
He will accept any small amount of service you do for him.
他接受任何奉献者供奉的哪怕一点点的这些奉爱服务，他都会接受。
And if he's satisfied, then your life is successful.
如果他满意了，奉献者便大功告成，成功了。
And when Lord Ramachandra went back to Godhead, when he left the material world, finished his pastime, and went back to the spiritual world, at that time he brought all the devotees of Ayodhya, he took them all back with him, back to Godhead.
当主 Ramachandra 完成他的这个逍遥时光回归守神的时候，他把 Ayodhya 的所有的奉献者都带回守神，回到守神内，回到宁静世界。
So this is the special advantage of worshipping Lord Ramachandra.
这是崇拜主 Ramachandra 的特别的好处。
And you get the same advantage when you worship Lord Chaitanya.
我们也有特殊的，当我们崇拜主 Chaitanya 的时候，也会有特殊的优势。
So we see Lord Krishna, Lord Rama, sometimes that they could kill the demons.
我们可以看到主 Krishna 和主 Ramachandra 有时候他会杀死恶魔。
But Lord Chaitanya gave love of God to the demons.
但是主 Chaitanya 他把爱，把对神的这个爱，甚至给予这个恶魔。
But Lord Ramachandra, Lord Krishna, and Lord Chaitanya, they delivered.Many of the people who were in their pastimes, who were present before with them in their leelas, and they delivered, took them back to Godhead.
在这个 Krishna, Ramachandra 以及主 Chaitanya 的这些逍遥时光中，他们都拯救了在他们面前出现的很多生物。
And we see Lord Chaitanya, he's got a form, Sadbhuj, where he shows himself to be not different from Lord Rama and Lord Krishna.
主 Chaitanya 也展示了他的 Sadbhuj, 六臂的这个形体。这表明他和主 Ramachandra 和主 Krishna 本人是没有区别的。
So Prabhupada says, we can achieve the purpose of human life by worshipping the Sadbhuj form of the Lord.
生怕怕地说，人体生命目标得以实现，我们可，就是说，为了实现这个目标，我们可以去崇拜这个主柴坦尼亚这个六臂形体。
Yeah, because then we're worshipping Rama and Krishna and Lord Chaitanya all in the one form.
在这个六臂形体，我们既崇拜了主 Ramachandra， 也崇拜了 Krishna， 也崇拜了主柴坦尼亚。
So we hear Hanuman's, or Sukadeva Goswami is speaking now, and he says that the glories of Lord Ramachandra are inconceivable.
这个时候 Sukadeva Goswami 就开始说了，说至尊人格守神 Ramachandra 的荣耀是不可思议的。
Or maybe he means not just Ramachandra, but the Supreme Personality of Godhead is inconceivable.
至尊人格守神的荣耀是不可思议的。
And when he comes in Bharatvarsh, he comes in the form of Naranarayan.
当他在 Bharatvarsha 之地的时候，他以 Naranarayana 的形体显现。
And he appears at Badrik Ashram in the Himalayas.
他在 Bhadrik Ashram 这个地方，在喜马拉雅山。
And he teaches them about religion, knowledge, renunciation.
他教导他的奉献者们宗教知识、气诀和灵性力量。
Teaches them sense control to get free from false ego.
感官控制以及摆脱假我。
And he has great austerities until the end of this. He's engaged in austerities. He's doing austerities until the end of this millennium.
直到这个年代的末尾，他都会一直从事苦行。
So it's possible to go there to Bhadrik Ashram. Of course, it doesn't mean if we go there, it doesn't mean we will see Nara Narayan. But he's there.
我们现在是可以去 Bhadrik Ashram, 但是呢，不是意味着说我们去到 Bhadrik Ashram, 喜马拉雅山就可以见到 Nara Narayan 的。
It's impossible to understand ourselves as a spiritual being if we just simply do speculation or material activities.
我们在这个物质世界不只是做这种物质的活动，物质的这种心智思辨的推敲和物质活动。
We have to be.
通过这两个方法是不可能觉悟自我的。
We have to be very serious if we want to achieve self-realization.
如果我们想觉悟自我的话，必须非常认真才行。
And we should be willing to do some austerity.
同时，我们也应该愿意去从事一些苦行。
But we know people in the Kali Yuga, they don't even know what austerity means.
但是在卡尼年代的人们甚至不知道什么叫做苦行。
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to teach the fallen souls the easy way to be self-realized.
因此，在这种情况下，主在这个年代显现为以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的形式降临到这个世界，告诉我们非常简单的方式用于觉悟自我。
He comes to teach everybody to chant the Hare Krishna mantra and do Krishna Sankirtan.
他告诉所有的人唱诵 Hare Krishna 曼陀罗，然后齐诵圣名的 Sankirtan。
So in the Kali Yuga, there's so many crazy philosophies, so many different ideas about how we can advance.
在这个卡尼年代，有很多非常邪、各种各样的这种主义啊，还有这种方法。来指导我们，告诉我们怎么样去进步。
And if we follow these processes, these crazy philosophies, then we'll waste our life.
但是如果我们追随这些，想去追随这些哲学的话，这些事情只是在浪费我们的生命。
We'll be cheated, and we'll just get no benefit at all.
我们只是会被欺骗，不会从中得到任何的受益。
Okay, any questions now?
Yes. And, 第一个问题来自 Pushpa Sara Madaji, Dimbai Gurudev, Dimbai 翻译。请问现在圣地的猴子也是纯粹奉献者吗？ The monkeys in the holy dam, are there pure devotees?
No.
不是的。
But...The residents of the dam, you have to respect them. You can't hit them or do anything with them.
但是他们是圣地的居民，我们不应该去伤害他们，或者说对他们做一些什么事情。我们应该尊重他们。
They're not ordinary living entities.
他们不是普通的生物。Next question. Next question from Hare Krishna. Dimbai Guru, 主是全知的，知道妻子希塔是纯洁的，为什么还会抛弃她呢？ Obeisance to Guru. The Lord can know everything, and he knows Mother Sita is pure. Why he give up Sita, abandon Sita?
Well, we just read Lord Ramachandra doesn't abandon her, although it appears like that.
我们刚刚读到了这个，他好像显得是放弃了西塔，但是实际上他没有放弃西塔。
No, he sent Sita back to the spiritual world.
在那一刻，西塔是回到了灵性世界。
And Lord Ramachandra is there in the spiritual world. So Sita went back to be with Lord Ramachandra in the spiritual world.
主 Ramachandra 也是永恒在灵性世界的，西塔回到了灵性世界跟主 Ramachandra 在一起。
Even though Lord Ramachandra appears to be in this world and performing Leela, he's also there in the spiritual world at the same time.
即便主 Ramachandra 在这个物质世界在上演逍遥时光，他仍然永恒的在灵性世界存在。
He can expand himself.
他可以扩展他自己。
Just like Krishna. Krishna does.
就像主 Krishna 一样。
Krishna never leaves Goloka Vrindavan, but he comes here.
Krishna 永远不会离开 Goloka Vrindavan, 但是 Krishna 又在这里。
So Lord Ramachandra also came here, and Mother Sita, she was with Lord Ramachandra for some time here, and we heard how Lord Ramachandra is teaching us about the nature of the duty of a husband, the duty of the difficulties of married life.
我们在这件事里我们学到就是主 Ramachandra 他永恒的在灵性世界，他在这个物质世界显现的是这样，但是呢，他做这一切的目的是为了我们在这个物质世界的婚姻生活是很艰难的，然后要做一个丈夫的责任也是很困难。
But the husband must take care for the wife.
但是一个丈夫必须很小心地照顾妻子。
So Lord Ramachandra had to go and when she was kidnapped, Lord Ramachandra had to go and get her back.
因此，当西塔母亲被这个绑架的时候，他得去把西塔母亲给救回来。
So some people say, yes, Lord Ramachandra is very cruel, he sent his wife away. He didn't send his wife away, it's mentioned very clearly here.
有一些人说这个主 Ramachandra 非常的残忍，他把西塔给流放了，但是在这里清楚地解释了这一点。
It's mentioned by Hanuman. Hanuman is, he knows better than us.
这里是哈努曼他亲自说的，哈努曼比我们更了解情况。Next question.
Yes.
From Gita Govinda Mataji, Hare Krishna, 感恩孤儿的仁慈，感恩翻译的仁慈。请问物质能量是死的、不动的，那杜尔嘎女神是物质世界的监督者。杜尔嘎女神和物质能量之间的关系又是什么呢？物质能量是虚幻的，但又是不动的，是怎么理解他们的关系呢？ This question have two parts. One part is, Hare Krishna, thanks Guru's mercy. I want to know, the material energy is death and cannot move automatically. So the Durga, Mother Durga is the God of the material world. So what's the relationship between the Durga and the material energy?
Well, Mother Durga, she's working on behalf of the Supreme Lord, right? We heard Lord Krishna or Lord Rama, they're not involved so much with the creation, maintenance and destruction.That's taken care of by Mother Durga.
我们知道 Durga 母亲，她是在这个至尊主的要求下去为这个物质世界，掌，就是说，在这个物质世界行事的。 因为主 Krishna 主 Rama 他不亲自的去处理这些物质世界的这些缘这些事情，主要是由 Durga 女神在做这些物质世界的事情。
This is stated in the Brahma Samhita。 Srishti Stiti Pralaya Sadhana Saktareka Chaye Vayashya Bhuvanani Vibharti Durga Echan Rupam Apiyashya Chachesta Desa Govinda Madhipursam Tamaham Bhajamin。 This is the verse sung by Lord Brahma, and he's describing how Mother Durga performs her work.
刚刚 Guru 念的这段祷文来自于 Brahma Samhita， 这是主 Brahma 他向这个主供奉的这个祷文，他描述了 Durga 女神是如何在行动的。
So Lord Brahma says, the creating, maintaining, and annihilating deity of the mundane world is worshipped by all people as Durga.
他说到创造、维系和毁灭这个事情是由这个人物是 Durga 女神所崇拜的这个人物。
And then Lord Brahma says, I adore.Mother Durga moves like a shadow under the control of the Supreme Lord.
Durga 母亲是至尊人格守神活动的一个影子。
So Brahma says, I worship Govinda, the primeval Lord, under whose direction Mother Durga conducts herself.
我崇拜至尊人格守神。Durga 女神在她的指挥下运作行工作。
So in Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says, "Maya jakshena prakriti siyute sacharacharam." He said, "This material nature is moving under my direction."
智者人格守神在薄伽梵歌中也说，这个物质世界的物质自然的这个能量，也是在我的指挥下运作。
So the material energy is moving.It's not Krishna doing it, he has it done by Durga under his direction.
物质能量它是不动的，它是在 Durga 女神的指挥下做的。
Yeah. So the material nature, it doesn't have consciousness, but it's under the control of Krishna.And Krishna has Durga facilitate to do everything.
物质能量它是没有生命力的，它是在主的控制下去运作的，而主让 Durga 女神在做这个事情。
Mm-hmm. What's the other question?
Other question is, the illusion power of the material world is not moving. How do you understand their relationship?物质能量是虚幻的，但又是不动的，怎么理解？The material energy is illusion, but cannot move. Is illusion, but at the same time cannot move. How to understand this relationship?
Material energy is
illusion.
Illusion.
But at the same time, it cannot move.
Mm-hmm.All right, so we have done, it's illusion in the sense that it's temporary. It's real, but it's temporary.
虚幻的意思是它是真实的，但是呢它是短暂的。
It's created,
物质能量是短暂的。
It manifests for some time, and then it's unmanifest.
就是说它有一段时间显现，有一段时间又不展示。
Everything.At the time of annihilation, everything enters into the body of Mahavishnu. It all comes from Mahavishnu, then it enters back into the body of Mahavishnu.
一切来自于主 Vishnu， 在毁灭的时候，所有的一切又归到 Mahavishnu 的体内。
One breath of Mahavishnu. That's what happens.
这是 Mahavishnu 的一呼一吸。
So it's illusory.But at the same, it's not moving. Yeah, it doesn't move because it doesn't have consciousness. So it can't move independently.
它不动，意思是它没有这种知觉，所以它不可能独自行动，它不可能独自移动。
嗯。还有问题吗
？Yes. Next question from Shyamakri. Hare Krishna, 领拜 Gurudev 和所有的奉献者。在这个诗节中，主 Ramachandra 和主 Krishna 没有分别，但是在大薄伽瓦坛中还是有分别，是吗？要不然 Gopal Kumar 在主 Ramachandra 那里怎么没有品尝到 Krishna 的全部快乐呢 ？A basis to Gurudev and all devotees.In these words, today we learn, the Ramachandra and the Krishna, they have no difference. But in the Brihat Bhagavatam, between the Ramachandra and the Krishna, they have the difference? If they don't have the difference, why the Gopal Kumar, when the Gopal Kumar go to the Ramachandra, the Gopal Kumar cannot taste all the happiness from the Ramachandra?
Yes, you have to understand they're playing different roles. It's the same person, Lord Rama and Lord Krishna are the same person. They're both the Supreme Lord, but they're playing different parts. Lord Rama comes as a king to show the duty of the king and how to be a king. And Lord Krishna, he's the original Supreme Lord.
是的。我们得理解主 Krishna 和主 Rama， 他们虽然是同一个人，但是他们扮演的不同的角色。主 Ramachandra 他扮演的是一个国王，而他告诉人们如何成为一个恰当的国王，如何恰当的履行自己的职责。而主 Krishna 他是原初的至尊人格守神本人。
Yeah, it's just that.As Lord Ramachandra, Krishna is not revealing himself fully because he's playing a different part. He has to play the part of Lord Rama, which is a special mood, but it's the same person.
主 Krishna 在 Rama 的身上没有完全的展示他自己，因为这是不同的心态。他展示的是一个国王。
Just like we say, Vishnu and Krishna are the same.
就像我们说 ，Krishna 和主 Vishnu 是同一个人。
But there's a difference. There is a difference. Vishnu is playing a different role. It's Krishna in a different role.
但是他们是有区别的。主 Vishnu 和他扮演的是不同的角色。
So it's like Lord Chaitanya's philosophy, oneness and different. Achincha beda beda tadva.
就像主 Chaitanya 告诉给我们的哲学，记忆记忆 ，Achincha beda beda tadva.
Lord Rama is one, not different from Krishna, but at the same time there is a difference, a little.
主 Rama 是一，他和 Krishna 没有区别，但是同时呢，他们又有一些区别。
You have to understand how the Lord has different functions. He has different, plays different parts for different devotees. It's for the pleasure of his devotees he does it. Because some devotees, they are attracted to him in the form of Lord Rama. And some devotees are attracted to him in the form of Krishna.
我们得了解，我们得理解主有不同的，有不同的形象，有不同的功能。有一些奉献者是被主 Rama 的这个品质所吸引，有一些人，有些奉献者是被主 Krishna 的品质所吸引。
So just like Hanuman only wants to serve Lord Rama. He knows Krishna is the original Supreme Lord, but still he just wants to be with Lord Rama and to serve Lord Rama. He's not attracted so much to be with Krishna.
就像哈努曼，他虽然知道主 Krishna 是至尊人格守神，但是呢，他仍然只被主 Ramachandra 所吸引，他只被主 Ramachandra 所吸引，他不被 Krishna 所吸引，他只想崇拜主 Ramachandra。
And we see in the Brihad Bhagavatamrita, when Gop Kumar came to Ayodhya, he saw Lord Rama. Oh, you know, he liked him, very attractive and everything. But Gop Kumar is attracted to Krishna.
当我们看到大伯加瓦坛的时候，我们看到 Gopa Kumar 他去到了 Ayodhya， 他虽然见到了主 Ramachandra， 但是他还是被主 Krishna 所吸引。
Because Gop Kumar, he's a cowherd boy from Vrindavan, from Govardhan.And he's still dressed as a cowherd boy, even when he went to the spiritual world and he went to Ayodhya and Vaikuntha, he was still carrying his flute and he was still as a cowherd boy because he's very attached to that identity.
Gopa Kumar 非常依附于他自己的身份，他是来自于噶尔瓦南山的一个木流童。他即便去到这个 Ayodhya， 去到灵性世界，去到其他地方的时候，他仍然是一个木流童的这个打扮，他总是拿着他的笛子。
So he really has to go to Goloka to see Krishna there.
所以他必须得去到 Goloka， 他得去那里见到 Krishna 才行。
To see Krishna as a cowherd boy in the mood of Vrindavan.
他想看到 Krishna 木流童的这个身份，他想看到 Krishna 在 Vrindavan 的这个心态。
Does it make sense?
这个你能理解吗？有意义吗？
I don't, who asked that question?
Shyamaki.
Who is that?
Sati Mataji, Shyamaki.
Shyamasaki.
Oh,
Shyamasaki.
Shyamaki.
Sorry.
Shyamasaki. Okay, good question, yes.
非常好的问题。Next question, Gurudev.
Okay.
Next question from Gita Govinda Mataji. Hare Krishna, 感恩 Guru 的仁慈，感恩翻译。我们崇拜主 Gauranitai 得到的仁慈，我们崇拜主 Gauranitai 会得到仁慈，那我们会和 Gauranitai 一起回到灵性世界，还是要看我们原初的心态是对主的哪个形象所信。Hare Krishna, thanks Guru's mercy. I want to know, when we worship the Gauranitai deity and we get the mercy from them.Are we go back to the Godhead with Gauranitai, or we should consider what's the original mood to the Vishnod and attractive by Vishnod, then we go to the that place?
No, you can go directly with Gauranitai.
我们是和 Gauranitai 直接回到灵性世界。
Lord Chaitanya, Lord Nityananda, they know everything.About Radha and Krishna. They can take us back to Godhead. They can take us to Goloka, Vrindavan.
主 Chaitanya, 主 Nityananda, 他知道一切，他可以直接把我们带到这个，他们知道 Radha, Krishna, 他可以直接把我们带到灵性世界。 She want to know, when we go back to the Godhead,shall consider the original mood of what Lord we are attractive.
What Lord? Well, Lord Chaitanya is the Lord.
主 Chaitanya 就是主。
You can go back to Godhead worshipping him. He has his own abode, he has his place there in Goloka Vrindavan.
Maybe she want to know if our original mood is also like the Hanuman.
Our original mood, how do you know what your original mood is?
我们如何知道我们的原初的心态呢？
You have to be attracted by one particular form of the Lord.
我们得被主的一个特定的形象所吸引。
And You know, if you're not meant to be worshipping that Lord, then when we go to the spiritual world, then we'll find out. Or even before we go to the spiritual world, our devotion will wander and we'll be attracted to some other form. There has to be some particular form of the Lord which is very, very attractive to us.
After we go back to the Godhead, we find which Lord we are attracted. Yes.
Even before you go back also.
即便在回到灵性世界之前，我们也得知道，或者说发现我们到底被主的哪个形象所吸引。
So、you take,
但是回灵性世界之后，我们也可以找到我们到底是被哪个形象所吸引。
You take up the worship of a particular form of the Lord, and you worship that form of the Lord. It becomes your mind becomes absorbed in meditating on that form.
我们去崇拜一个特定的形象，我们在崇拜这个特定的形象，我们的心意完全被吸引的这个时候。
And when we give up our body at that time, that because we're thinking of the form of the Lord, we'll go to that place.
当我们放弃躯体的时候，我们会想着这个我们生前所崇拜的这个形象，然后我们去到哪个地方。
However, if somehow for some reason we're not so satisfied there, or we're thinking about something else, we're not, you know, we don't feel quite the pleasure which we thought we'd feel, then maybe we're meant to be somewhere else.
如果在那个时候，就是说回去了之后，我们在那个时候对，还是觉得有一些些不适应，或者说那个的时候，我们还是会去到别的地方。
Now some people, they worship Krishna, some people worship Lord Rama, some people worship Lord Nrsingadev, some people worship Lord Varaha. So different deities are there.
在那里有一些人有一些人是崇拜主 Krishna, 有一些人是崇拜 Rama, 有一些人是崇拜 Varaha.
So we have to be cautious and consider,which particular form are we really most attracted to and devote ourselves to that form? So Lord Chaitanya is very merciful. He's the most merciful and he's the easiest form to worship.
We have to consider whether we are attracted to the Lord Chaitanya's particular form. But the Lord Chaitanya is the most merciful and the most merciful.
And in the Kali Yuga, it's very appropriate for us to worship Lord Chaitanya and to chant the holy name. He's very happy when we chant the holy name, and we will also become happy.
在卡利年代，崇拜主柴坦尼亚是非常恰当的。他非常希望我们唱诵 Hare Krishna, 唱诵主的圣名。当我们唱诵主的圣名的时候，他就会很高兴。Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from the Hari Vamsa Prabhu. 这种吸引的差别是不是就是灵魂的个体性？有没有可能无法做出选择的状态？Two-part question. The first is, the difference between the difference attraction between the different souls. Is that mean the living soul's identity?
Yes, different. Of course, we're all individuals. We have our individual identity, so there will be differences.
是的，我们是个体，我们是每一个不同的独立的个体的灵魂，我们有我们自己的身份。
Everyone's an individual, and we have individual tastes, individual likes and dislikes.
每一个人都是独立个体的，每一个人都有自己独立特定的喜欢喜好。
What else is asking?
are there some conditions we can't choose what we choose, what we like?
Well, of course we can choose what we like, but what we like is what we are conditioned by due to our past, due to past activities, past association. That influences what we like.
当然我们是可以做出选择的，我们的选择是基于过去我们的涟漪，我们的这个奉献服务。
Everyone, you can say you have free will, but actually our free will is not really, our free will is to choose between Krishna and Maya.
我们的个体性是在 Krishna 和 Maya 之间做出选择。
Other than that, you don't have free will. Other than that, you're controlled by the modes of nature.
除了这个之外，我们就被这个物质自然所控制。
By the modes of nature, we're controlled to do different things and to like different things and not like things. It's due to our association with the material energy.
在物质自然的控制下，在物质能量的影响下，我们会有不同的涟漪，有不同的喜好。
So you're never independent except when it's either when you choose between Krishna and Maya. That's your free will.
别的情况下我们是无法独立的，我们的这个独立性就体现在我们选择是 Krishna 还是在选择 Maya.
And when you choose Krishna, then you're also controlled. You're under the protection of the divine energy. Krishna takes care of the devotees.
当我们选择 Krishna 的时候，我们也是被 也是受到照顾的。Krishna 照顾我们。
Mahatmanastu mamparta devim prakriti mashrita bhajanti ananya manaso gyatva bhutadim avyayam. The great souls are under the protection of my divine energy.
这些伟大的灵魂在我的超，在我的神圣的能量保护之下。
So either way we're controlled. We're either controlled by Krishna or we're controlled by Maya. But we can choose.Do you want to be with Krishna or do you want to be in Maya?
我们要么是被 Krishna 的能量所控制，要么就是被 Maya 的能量所控制，看我们选择是哪一个。
At every moment, we have a choice to choose Krishna or Maya.
在任何一种一个状态之下，我们都有可以选择，我们可以选择是被 Krishna 控制，还是选择被 Maya 控制。
Any other questions?
Next question from Hani, Dimbai Guru. 我现在的还是根据自己的喜好、感受、情绪做出服务，也很关注世俗的话题。我觉得有时服务会很挣扎。奉献服务如何变得更稳定、更纯粹一些呢？ Now I also do what I like, and by the motion I do the devotional service.I also concern about the material topic. Sometimes I feel the devotional service also make me hard, difficult. So how to make the devotional service more easy and more pure, more steady?
Well, join the Sankirtan movement and go for Sankirtan, do more Kirtan.
那就请你参加 Sankirtan 的运动，去做更多的一些唱诵，参加这样的唱诵的活动。
You know, I don't really know enough about what you're doing to understand why it's so difficult for you.
我不知道为什么，我不知道你做了一些什么，然后你会觉得做这些事情会感觉到对你来说这么困难。
Who is this? Who asked this question? Hari?
Honey.
Bali.
Honey. H-O-N-E-Y. Honey.
H-O-N-E-Y.
Yes.
Honey.
Yeah, honey.
Honey. Oh. Well, you know, the honey is not saying enough about what they're doing for me to be able to give much advice. But generally, if you join Sankirtan and go for chanting Hare Krishna, then everything becomes clear.
哈尼这个奉献者他并没有描述他的具体是一种什么样情况下，但是通常情况下，如果一个人参加Sankirtan去做唱诵的话，一切都会变得很清晰、很简单。
You know, when I first became a devotee, I remember, you know, we were making incense, and I was looking after this incense business, and you know, I would get really mental about everything, but whenever I would go on Sankirtan, then my mind would become clear.
当我最开始加入这个奉献服务的时候，我就被要求去做这个香的一些生意。我每天都会为这个香的这个事情所操心，但是呢，后来我当我开始加入到这个Sankirtan唱诵队伍的时候，我的内心就变得清。 就是清楚起来，清晰起来。
So it really helps a lot if you can get the chance to join Sankirtan and go and chant and just forget about all the material things and you know, just immerse yourself in the holy name.
如果你参加Sankirtan的话，这对你非常有帮助，你会忘掉所有的物质上的这些事情，只是让你的自己沉浸在这个
Lord Chaitanya said how it cleanses, Chaito Dharpana Marjanam cleanses the mirror of the mind. And then he says, Param Vijayate, all glories to the Sri Krishna Sankirtan.
Krishna的这个唱诵。Yeah.
We can, by Sankirtan, we can taste the full nectar for which we are always anxious.
我们通过Sankirtan齐颂圣名的这一个运动，我们总是可以品尝到甘露，而当我们处在焦虑的时候，我们总是能品尝到这个Sankirtan的这个甘露。
So it's really important to, you know, just try to get away from the material world and to bring ourselves up to this transcendental platform by chanting the holy name and getting good association with devotees, having nice kirtan, and then
通过,
very powerful.
通过念诵和奉献者联谊，参加好的这种唱诵，这是非常好的一种方法，也是非常重要的，把我们从这种麻烦的物质世界提升到这个 Krishna 知觉的一个非常好的方法。
Sometimes people think, oh, I don't have time for that, or they're thinking, oh, that's strange, that's weird. But if you do it, if you just go and do it, you'll see it's so helpful, it's so good for us.
有些时候人们会说，哎呀，我没有时间，而且这个唱诵有点太夸张了。但是呢，如果你真的加进去，你加入到这个唱诵过程中去，你真的会发现这个唱诵对我们来说非常非常的好，非常有帮助，非常有力量。
You can also think about taking part in book distribution, trying to distribute books.
你也可以考虑参加这个派书的这个运动，你也可以尝试做一些派书的活动。Give
some books to people. Tell them about Krishna.
把书给予一些人们，告诉别人 Krishna.
It's good to do preaching, to go and preach. Preaching means to tell people about Krishna.
去传播是非常好的。 传播的意思是告诉别人有关 Krishna。
Even if you don't speak about Krishna, if you just speak about the mind and the senses and how we're all struggling with our senses and mind, and how chanting the mantra can help us.
即便你不谈论 Krishna, 你只是谈论这个我们的心意感官是如何挣扎受到骚扰的，然后呢，我们通过唱诵 Hare Krishna 如何能够帮助我们。
It's really important for us to get a taste for talking this kind of knowledge, for sharing this knowledge with other people.
当我们把 Krishna, 当我们把这一切和别人去分享的时候，这也能够提升我们的这个品味。
This is the real business of a devotee.
这是奉献者真正的工作。
It's described in Bhagavad Gita like that.Machita madgata prana bodhayantas parasparam katayantas chamam nidyam tushyanti cha ramanti cha. Lord Krishna is telling Arjuna that the thoughts of my pure devotees dwell in me, their lives are surrendered to me, and they derive great satisfaction and bliss by enlightening one another and conversing about me.
主 Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》中也说到，那些我的纯粹奉献者，他们总是在和别人的相互谈论和给别人的启发中，获得我。
Yeah, so sharing topics, spiritual knowledge, sharing it. Don't just keep it for ourselves. If we keep it for ourselves, that's miserly.It's important for us to be generous and distribute and share what we have.
分享而不要变得吝啬。吝啬的意思是我们把这个事情老藏在、老保护在、老藏在自己的身上，而我们应该去分享，把这个把分享与别人分享这个 Krishna。
嗯。So I hope that helps you a little.
我希望这些能帮助你，对你有一点点帮助。
Hare Krishna, good day.
嗯。
哈利他说，我的主要问题是不能早起念诵，不爱读经典，经常浪费时间在一些无关紧要的事情上，而且不是特别喜欢清洁，然后不爱做饭等等这些问题。
What does she like to do?
她到底喜欢做什么事情呢？
She has to develop a taste for these things.
她应该发展一些，发展出对做这些事情的品味。
She has to understand working for Krishna is fun, that it's a lot of pleasure to work for Krishna.
他得找到为 Krishna 工作的乐趣，在为 Krishna 服务和工作的时候，会有很多的喜乐、快乐在这个里面。
Even you're cleaning the toilets and sweeping and cleaning, what doing the laundry, whatever you're doing, it's fun. You do it for Krishna.
即便你在打扫马桶、厕所，或者说清洁这个在洗衣服的时候，你为 Krishna 工作会有很多的乐趣。
So, in the material world, I know to do these things is boring, we don't like, but when we do it in Krishna consciousness, it's pleasure.
我知道在这个物质世界，做这些事情是很无聊，很厌烦的，但是如果为 Krishna 去做的话，是有很多的快乐在里面的。
But she has to have that proper understanding, the proper attitude that I'm doing this for Krishna, I'm his servant.
但是她得对这些事情有一些恰当的理解。我们是 Krishna 的仆人，我们做这些事情是为了 Krishna 而做。
Mm-hmm. So, you know, I don't know, I mean... A bit difficult, you know. I mean, there has to be something she likes to do. Does she sing? Does she dance?
他得有一些事情是他喜欢做的。他喜欢唱歌和跳舞吗？
Does she like eating?
他喜欢吃吗？
，我们不知道这位哈米是哪里的奉献者，休息了多长时间，可能还是一个新人吧。
She didn't see what she liked, did she? She didn't see what she likes to do.
她没有说出她到底喜欢做的事情是什么。
她没有说她。
她说喜欢吃不喜欢做。
She liked to eat, but don't like to do.
Okay, she has to learn to do.
他得学着去做。
Okay.
Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from Priya. 顶拜 Guru, 请问崇拜照片跟立体的神像是不是一样都可以回到主 Krishna 的身边呢？ When I worship the pictures or the deities, they all, we all can go back to the.Godhead?
Yes.
是的。
No difference. Krishna's in his picture.
Krishna 也在他的照片里面。
Any other question? Are you waiting on?
没有了。
Oh.
目前。
Okay. 我们时间到了，差不多。
好的。
Okay, Ganshi Suguri-rai, give woman Jing Tai Fani. Ganshi Sati Tujer. Ganshi Soyo de Functions, Ling Ting, Tiwen, Shishi Niman, Chufu Niman, Chuan Chao Sun Li. Wanshi Rui, Haribo, Srila Prabhupada Ki.
Jai.
Gaur Bhakti Vrinda Ki.
Jai.
注意，我们还有三天呢，咱们这儿又还没结束，还有时间。Hare Krishna，
谢谢 Gurudev。